Oh, there we go. What is up, homies? My name is Felix, and I'm here back again with another video for you all today. And today in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make a Hooligan Chase type beat. And if by some chance you don't know Hooligan Chase, just kidding, but you should know who he is because he's a super fire, super underrated rapper and producer. I've been a huge fan of Hooligan Chase since probably like 2017, 2018 or so. So yeah, make sure you go check out his music if you haven't already. So what he does with a good majority of his beats is that he'll find a really fire old sample, take that and then just put some fire trap drums over it. And then just add in a couple weird vocal samples and then you're pretty much good to go. So yeah, make sure you guys check out my Instagram and my SoundCloud down in the description below, along with playlists of songs I produce, my beat store, my Discord, all that stuff. Go check it out if you'd like to do so. Also, feezostore.com. Go cop yourself some fire merch. We got hoodies, shirts, long sleeves, crew necks, anything you could possibly desire. So yeah, now we can get into this video. So here we are inside FL Studio, which is actually what Chase uses for all his producing and mixing and mastering and everything. So yeah, he's part of the FL gang too, so I gotta respect that for sure. But as I mentioned, it usually starts off with some old, really super fire sample. And a lot of the samples he uses are kind of like upbeat and almost more on like the soulful side of things. But then also some of his songs have more like dark and mysterious type melodies. So it's up to you what you want to pick. Honestly, if you hear a sample and you think, wow, this would be dope with some trap drums over it, you pretty much got what you're looking for. And if you don't know how to find cool old songs to sample and stuff like that, what I would recommend is just go onto YouTube, search up samples or songs to sample, samples for beats, or whatever different variation of that, and you'll probably get a bunch of playlists of people's that have like 500 plus songs in them of just a bunch of old songs. You can sift through there and look for some really cool old samples. So anyways, the sample that I'm gonna be working with here today is this one.
Holy hole in a donut!
And I guess this is actually from the old Batman show soundtrack, which is pretty dope. I was debating leaving this first part in here.
Holy hole in a donut!
And then having all the drums drop in and everything, but I think I have another sample that I want to use for that instead. So yeah, anyways, what I'm going to do is basically just select the portion that I want to be the main sample, which is going to be this right here. And then I'm just going to drag this bad boy in here like this, and then we're going to stretch it so it fits with the tempo and everything. So now I'm going to take this and I'm going to pitch it down by like 400 cents. And most of the Hooligan Chase songs I hear are around like 130 to 160. That's a pretty common tempo for most of his beats. So yeah, I'm honestly just going to have this playing pretty much throughout the whole beat. I need a chiropractor ASAP. So now that we have the first part of the beat, we need the second part of the beat, which is the fire trap drums. Honestly, a lot of the time, he'll just keep his beats super, super simple because his flow and his vocals are just so clean that it honestly is like the main focus of the track a lot of the time. Probably my favorite Hooligan Chase song ever is Nice and Smooth, and that literally just has the most basic drums ever, but it's so fire. But anyways, we're just going to start off with the basic snare placement just like this. And I will change it up a little bit later, but for now, we're just gonna put in a simple two-step hi-hat pattern. And for the kick pattern, it's usually not super overcomplicated. You wanna have just something like this. Or even simpler is fine too. It just kinda depends on the song. On the last two bars here, I just added a little accent snare just for some nice effect. And then I'm just gonna put in the open hat like right after every two snare hits. So right here, and then right there. One thing I always like to do with my hi-hats is go in here to this little wrench tab and then turn the shift up just a little bit. And that basically takes your hi-hats and just does this with them. And that just makes it sound a little less robotic. I'm not sure if he does that or not, but it sounds nice to do it. Okay, so now at this point, what I'm gonna do is work on the 808 pattern. I definitely know at least a few of you out there struggle with this. So I'm gonna show you guys how to figure out your 808 pattern for when you're using a sample and not like a melody that you made. So usually the first step for me is just to create a new pattern and then just click the pattern in like every 4 bars or 8 bars. And now you can play the sample while editing your 808. And the first thing we're gonna do is just put a note in here and then bring it way up. So hit control and then up on your keyboard. So we have this really high-pitched 808 sound. And when you have the 808 pitched up really high, it's way easier to hear all of the frequencies and the harmonics or whatever other fancy words within the actual 808 sample, because when you pitch it down like this, you cannot tell what note this is all the way down here. So now I'm gonna play the sample and drag this around until we match it up with the bass note. So if you try to listen for the bass note in the sample, it's gonna sound like... So those are the notes that you should be looking for. Hear how that's the same note as the bass that's playing in the sample? So that's what we want, essentially. So yeah, pretty much just try to listen out for the bass notes of your sample and match them up as best as you can. Honestly, having a good 808 pattern that's in key and has the right balance is really, really crucial for these type of beats. Because we don't have like a million different sounds and a bunch of different components to this beat, it's really important that we get every single sound right. So once you have the bass notes figured out, what I would recommend is just cutting this and then pasting it back into the other drum pattern. Now you can work on adding a little bit of bounce with these 808s. I wouldn't go too crazy, but you can just do some stuff like this where you do a couple little higher up notes. So this right here is kind of just a simple spins 808. A lot of times you'll have like a way more distorted 808. Probably an 808 that sounds like this would be a little bit better. But you can honestly just add some camel crusher or whatever other distortion you want on there. So I think I mentioned that a lot of times he'll just have a simple two-step hi-hat pattern, but I'm gonna add some rolls in here. So what we're gonna do is just go in and then just add a few little accent notes in here. Also, I'm gonna alternate the velocities. So it's gonna be like one is a little bit louder, one's a little bit quieter, one's a little bit louder, one's a little. So at this point, we're pretty close to being done with this beat. Like I said, super simple, nothing too crazy. Right now we got this going on. And it does sound fire, but there is one main problem with it. With this sample, the way it is, it fills up a lot of the frequency range. So what we want to do is cut out a lot of the high end so that the vocals can sit on top of it. And also cut out some of the low end so that our 808 is not clashing with the sample at all. And now we're going to solo this and then just put a little EQ action on it. So one of my favorite plugins for sampling is called MDA Degrade, and this might seem kind of counterintuitive because I'm using like an already old lo-fi kind of sample. So I use this on old songs where something is like super far panned to the right and like something super far panned to the left where it's pretty much like unfixable and I want it to be more mono. This plugin does wonders for that because sometimes just panning it doesn't do exactly what you need. But yeah, so I'll basically just turn up the headroom and then just turn up all these settings pretty much. You can hear the difference. This is the plugin off, and this is when it's on. Now the sample is super mono and it almost sounds like more old in a way. So one thing I want to add is a little vocal sample in here, and the one that I have I think is super dope. Alright, so this is what I'm thinking right here.
One of America's two most powerful villains of the next decade is turned loose to strike terror into the hearts of men.
And then all the drums drop in right there, and I think that's gonna be super, super fire. What I might also do is add a little tape stop onto the sample so that it cuts out when he says,
Terror into the hearts of men is turned loose to strike terror.
I pretty much only have stock effects plugins on this beat, and my CPU is still 70%. How? Literally how? Normally what I would do here is add a little crash sound because I think it's a really nice transition. But I did check, and a lot of times Hooligan Chase doesn't actually use a crash sound as a transition. He just brings the drums in right away. So that is what we're gonna do for this beat. So yeah, that is pretty much gonna do it here. The only other thing is I might add a couple more little vocal samples in different parts of the beat. And then obviously I'm gonna do the usual, switching up some of the drums every once in a while, taking out the open hi-hat here and there. And obviously I still have to mix this and everything. If you need help with mixing your beats, I did a tutorial on that right there that you can click on. But yeah, honestly, that is pretty much gonna do it for me in this video. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I think the beat turned out really fire. And if you didn't know about Hooligan Chase before, hopefully I was able to put you onto some of his music. But yeah, let me know if you guys have any questions down in the comments below. Also make sure you guys check out my Instagram and my SoundCloud down in the description below, along with the playlist of songs I produced, my beats on our Discord, all that stuff. Go check it out if you'd like to do so. feezostore.com, and I will see you guys next time.
One of America's two most powerful villains of the next decade is turned loose to strike terror into the hearts of men. Responsible for much of the popularity. Audiences love to hate.